Hello friends, welcome to Indian Eats. Today, let's see how to make boneless biryani. This is a special boneless biryani. You know, this is not just regular boneless biryani because we are going to add some chicken 65 pieces to it. You know Hyderabadi biryani, right? This is same as Hyderabadi biryani, but instead of regular chicken or boneless chicken, we are going to add some chicken 65 to it to make this special boneless biryani. So let's see how to make this special boneless biryani. I'm going to use the chicken 65 I already have with me, which I made it. For that, just watch my video which I have already made on chicken 65. I'm going to add it in the suggestions. It's going to pop up right on top of this video. Please watch this video if you want to look at like how to make the chicken 65 for this biryani. Now let's see how to make this biryani. If you have a biryani handy, please go ahead and use it. If not, don't worry. Use any kind of pan with which has a thick base. If not, you can use roti or dosa pan to make underneath it to make it thick. Now add some oil, and once hot enough, add some onions, like finely sliced onions. You can do it with your slicer or do it like julienne with your knife, and then add it to that and let them fry till golden brown. Once they are fried till golden brown, add some cilantro and mint to it. And then this is a tricky part here. Take some ginger, garlic and green chilies and make a paste out of it. Make sure you don't forget green chilies, or if you have ginger garlic paste, use the ginger garlic paste and add some green chili paste to it. If not, add three of them and make a paste and add it to this one. This is the one which gives you a nice flavor to this biryani. Once this fried for like 1 to 2 minutes, add some tomatoes to this one and let them cook for at least 4 to 5 minutes so that like all the tomato gets mashed up into this masala. Once this is cooked well, let's start adding dry masalas. Coriander powder, jeera powder, chili powder, salt, and biryani masala. You know, in biryani masala, I have a video for that biryani masala. Instead of using regular garam masala, you can use biryani masala. And now mix this masalas and let it fry for at least 1 minute or 2 minutes. That's it. And turn off the flame and put it aside. Now, once you put it aside, add some beaten yogurt to this and mix it up well. Once that's done, add some lemon juice to it. And now let's see how to make rice. So this is the tricky part. So take the quantity of rice, wash it and soak it in some water and put it aside. And now get a pot and fill it up with water to cook this rice and add the dry garam masalas now, like bay leaf, cinnamon stick, biryani flour, it's an optional thing, cloves, elachi, like cardamom, sajira to this, and add some salt. Make sure you had enough salt. When you taste this water, the water should be salty, because like rice is only consuming enough of water, so the salt should be good enough. Like if you add more, don't worry about it, but the water should be salty. Add some ghee to this one, or oil, whichever you like, and a little bit of lemon juice to it, and let it boil for at least 15 to 20 minutes. When the water is boiling, take a cup of water from this one, flavored water, add it to the masala. That's one of the best part you're gonna do, because it's gonna add a lot of flavor. Now come back to the water pot and add the soaked rice to it, and let it at least sit there for 10 minutes, because that's when your rice would be starting boiling. You know, it starts dancing. In the meantime, go to the masala bowl and add all the chicken 65 pieces to it and keep it ready for the biryani. And now you see that the rice is boiling, right? It's boiling and it's all dancing in the water. This is the right time you have to start keep checking. Maybe the first time the rice would be breaking. That's not the right time. You need to keep checking. After maybe 5 minutes or 4 minutes, you would see the rice would get a little softer. You know, that's when you would feel the rice is like 80% done, you know, 90% done. You have to take out this rice when it is 80 to 90% done and top it off on the chicken 65 masala. You know, the biryani masala and the chicken 65 pieces, and top it off. And once you top off all the rice in layers, add some ghee to it. Add some ghee and some color. You know, I always use natural colors to it. So I use color to give it like extra color to this particular biryani. And once that's done, add some cilantro and mint to it. And a tricky part here to give you a nice restaurant style taste, add some rose water and kevda water to this biryani. It gives you a nice restaurant style aroma to your biryani. Now add extra whatever the remaining chicken 65 pieces is, and seal the biryani lid and keep some weight if you possible to seal the dum this to seal all the vapor, and let it sit there for on high heat on high flame for 5 minutes. And after that, reduce the flame to low and let it cook for 15 minutes on low flame and turn it off after 15 minutes and don't take off the lid immediately. Wait for at least 20 minutes to take off the lid so that like all the vapor which is packed inside would settle down within the biryani to keep in the flavors inside the biryani. And let's see how this comes out now. There you go, friends. Let's open it now. See that? There it comes. There it comes. Yep. There you go. See how yummy it looks? It looks yummy, right? So colorful, all the chicken 65 pieces. Now let's look at the masala, you know, the chicken 65 pieces with masala just intact. And you look at the rice now. The rice grains, each and every individual grain is cooked well and it's all separate. You know the trick what we used here? Few lemon drops in the water while we were cooking it. Don't overdo the rice on top of while you're layering it. Keep it less in weight for individual rice to stay separate. This is how it is. This is an awesome recipe, guys. Please try it at your home. Enjoy it with your family and let us know how this came out in the comment sections of our video. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please share, subscribe and like this video and let your friends know as well. See you soon with another video at Indian Eats. Thank you again and bye.